The idea of this presentation is to show what I've done last year at Arquivo, so what happened in 2020 regarding image search. So just to contextualize a little bit, why does image search matter for the web? So these two charts here represent the share of different types of search on like search engines in general. So you can see on the leftmost chart, like you have Google with 62% of the share of web searches, Google Images with 22%, and then the smaller players with percentages below 5%. So the idea here is that if you take these different players and turn them into like just web and image search, which is what we have at Arquivo, and to make this more comparable, we can see that 1 in 4 searches in the web is for images. You can see here, like this page search is an aggregate of Google, Bing, Yahoo, and all the ones that have web search, and the image search is mostly just Google because no one else has it at that scale. So 1 in 4 web searches is for images. And then I did also an interesting experiment internally using our analytics tools to see what people use when they use Arquivo.pt's search. So we can see that about 89% is Wayback, which is to consult and to see the pages from the past. About 9% is page search and 2% is image search. But if we do the same exercise of just taking stuff that is directly comparable, we can see that about 1 in 5 searches in Arquivo is for images, which is quite interesting because it's not that far from web search in general, meaning that even in archives, people are interested in image search. So as of January 2020, which is actually did not change until January 2021, like right now, Arquivo's image search supports keyword search, sentence search, like phrase search, a set of words that must be together. And it has a couple of filters that make it the biggest, that are the biggest differentiator between Arquivo's web search, image search and general web search. So we can filter by time, which is the main difference between general web search and Arquivo archive web search. We can filter by size, file type, but time here is the most important thing because if you go to general web search, you will only find the latest version of a page, the latest version of anything, and all the scoring will be biased towards recency. So the main differentiator is how we can incorporate time as a part of search and make time something important. So just a general indicator of scale, we have indexed about 22 million image indexed. So these are just some general statistics, but the most jarring thing, one of the most strange things I found out when I arrived, is that we only had 22 million images indexed of a total of about 6 billion collected files, I'll say billion, using the American short scale. And of this, about 1.6 billion would be images. So why? One of the things I was tasked to do, and one of the first things I done, was find out why this discrepancy was so high, why there was this such large difference between the images we collected and the image we had on the index. Because it was initially designed as a prototype, but this change, this such large difference was not supposed to exist. So this was one of the opportunities for improvement. The other ones are the lack of image-specific metadata, which is directly related to your work. Like of our images, we were using HTML pages to find related information. So for each image, we would find the alt or title, the alt text or the title text. And about 42% of the images we had no identifying alt or title, meaning that the metadata we could find would be only to the page, like the page title or the image URL, meaning that these images would be very hard to contextualize in search. So the other things are like the prototype only indexed the oldest page for each image, meaning that if an image appeared on a lot of pages, we will only find the first one. And the ranking did not take into account this time information and this multiple collection process, because an image may be collected more than once and a page may be collected more than once in an archive. So just a general overview, the prototype only indexed like images that were found on image tags, but I extended this to find images that were referenced as a link, as an A tag. Images that are in CSS backgrounds, in base 64, set by JavaScript, and on the newer HTML image tags like figure and picture. So this is a general statistic of what we found. About 90% of the images are in image tags, 9% are in A links, in links, and CSS just makes up a very small percentage of images. The same is with base 64 images, which are only a very small percentage of images. Most images are image files. An interesting challenge I set up was as I described, about 40% of the images we found did not have captions. So what I did was to try to find a way to segment the page to find which segment of the HTML was in reference to an image. So there is a lot of research on this topic, but the problem is with these articles is that they are very computationally intensive. Some of them use visual segmentation, so they do an image-like analysis of the page. They take a screenshot of the page and analyze that. Or some others require parsing through the DOM of the page more than once to find where you have large jumps in structure. So what I did, as we have a very large amount of data, was to find a simplified technique that could work as well or almost as well, but be scalable and we could be able to deploy. So my idea was to, like, if you have an image on an HTML structure, you go up the structure of the tree of the HTML until you find a node that has text. So usually you have an image, and if a page is well structured or reasonably structured, as I described them, an image will be enclosed in a block that has some text, which would be the caption, or will be text that is next to it on the page, like a paragraph below or above. So this will work if a page is reasonably structured, but there are some pages where everything is on the same level. So if you imagine a blog where you have a sequential structure, you have a title, an image, a caption, a title, an image, a caption. You can only, if you go up the DOM enough times until you reach the head or like the body tag, what can happen is that the image, the first parent of the image with text will have all the text in the page. So in that case, especially for blogs, what I do is to go and find which are the nodes with text that are next and previous with the image, if you look at the page sequentially, and try to imagine if it is a blog, try to find the title and the caption. So if you had a blog that had football and a picture of Ronaldo and a picture of Messi, at least this way you'll find the text that is closest right after and right below the structure. So this is regarding metadata, so I'll do this quickly because if you're interested you can ask questions later. I can go into more detail about one of these. So one of the things we do, if you're familiar, I don't know if you're familiar with WARC structure, WARC archive. Basically when we crawl a web page, we store everything that arrives to our browser, our virtual browser, let's call it like that, in an archive that will, like, first we'll visit the HTML and then we'll try to download that content. And these archives are basically just a set of records, like you can have in the same record an HTML page, a JavaScript file, CSS file, an image, etc., etc. So if you have this, basically, everything is stored together. You find on the web like a raw copy of the server, even including the headers, main type, everything. But why does this matter when we index this? So what happens is we visit a page, and to ease the processing of these records, we split these records at 100 megabyte chunks. So we don't have everything, so we can process them easily in the future and do the playback process. So what can happen is that you can have a page in one archive and an image in another. So if you try to map them together to find which image is mentioned on which page, means that you cannot just look into a single archive and have that guarantee. You have to process them all and group them after. So what happens is that we gather this information. Basically, when we process work, we'll find all the images and all the pages, and find on the pages, if you have an image tag, you have a link to an image. So we add that to, basically, what you do to aggregate is aggregate stuff by the image URL. So even if the HTML and the image are in different works, in the end, using an Hadoop process, they will map into the same key and they will be grouped together, so we can find an image itself, like the image record, the image bytes, and all the HTML references to that image. In the end, we group this information so we can find the caption in the process I discussed previously, and find all the image-specific information, like the bytes themselves, like the... I'll describe more in the next slide what we do. But like the image information itself, the height, the width, the MIME type, the URL, etc. So the idea is that group this by URL so we can find all the images that reference, all the pages that references an image, and in the end remove all the information that's duplicate. So the thing here is in archiving, we capture the pages and the images multiple times. So most of this stuff will be duplicated. So if you find the capture an image today and tomorrow, it probably will not change. The same for the HTML that references it. So in general, there would be multiple things that we could do, like index every pair of images and HTML documents that we have, which will result in a lot of redundant information. Use only the oldest, which was the process that we did. So if we have a crawl, we know what we crawled first. We know like the age, in a way, of that page. Not exactly, but the time we crawled that page. So the page was like that at that time. Or what we did is that basically to avoid duplicating a lot of information, just keep the reference to the oldest page that references the image, and add all the new image-specific information, like the title, the alt text, or the caption, to the documents of all the next pages that reference that image to the same document. So we only have one page, but we have all the metadata that references an image. So another interesting thing here is that although like different images can have, different images have different URLs in general, but what can happen is you can have images that are under different URLs, but they are the same. So we group this information like under different digests. So we do an image digest so we can find which images bytes are the same, and we group it again. So if you have images, image files that are the same under different URLs, they will be under the same record. This is also performed at indexing time, because we index this by collection, but this is not, this is more of a detail than anything. So in terms of scale, which was one of the most, the things that I noticed more before. So this is the same site as before. As of January 2020, we had 20 million images. Out of this collected 1.6 billion. After I improved this process, basically find out what was happening, like some images were not being parsed, the Hadoop process had some problems, meaning that jobs could fail and images will not be added to the queue. And different types of collections that we do here at the archive do not have different characteristics, meaning that different images will be fine as a percentage of documents. I arrived at like we could jump from these 20 million images to 200 million or 650 million. And the pages that reference them would be in the order of the 1 billion even, if possible. So this is what I estimated in May last year. And what happened is that, my predictions were right, but only in the top end. So what happened is that we found out, that we actually had 654 million images and the 1.2 billion pages that reference these images. But the archive kept growing in 2020, so in 1 year we added 316 million images and 609 million pages, which is a 48% and 49% growth, which is terrifying for this is the final values that we have as of 2021. And this is terrifying because someone has to index this, which is me, which is I'm doing right now, and make this available for everyone for search in a reasonable time period, which is in the order of the seconds. So just one an interesting fact, that the duplication of image pairs that I described before means that if we did not did this deduplication, we would have 1.8 billion pairs in documents to index. And after this deduplication, we store only the oldest document, but all the page metadata, we will arrive at only 584 million documents, meaning that there was a large reduction on the information we have to index, which is mostly duplicate, but the quality will not be affected because most of the unique information is kept. The next stage that I'll be working on is how to index this. I'm working with Solar Cloud, but the summary is that we found more metadata for image. We improved the not safe for work image detection process, which is sort of related to what we do, but we only currently running if the image is not safe for work or not. Improve the architecture, and we are working on the research search right now. And the plan for the future, which is the thing you'll describe right after this is was basically part of our plan, because there is still a discrepancy between this basically in the same scale, this 654 million images and 1.6 billion images. So as you can see, there are still a lot of images that we are not indexed. So they are not indexed because we cannot find pages that reference them. So there is no useful metadata to have to index them. So one of our ideas would do some deep image classification, tag extraction, or caption extraction to see if we can find any useful information for these images. Do content-based hashes, because images, basically our digest is based on the content, but if you have two images that are, the content is the same, but they are different resolutions, they will still be considered different documents by our process. And actually the ranking part, which will be done after this, is now that we have all this information about the images that we didn't have before, how we can use it for ranking. So this is the end of my presentation. If you have some question or something you'd like to me to talk about more, I'd be delighted to keep going.